Gentleman's game. Make a gentleman's bet.
I'm betting large, Bill.
That ain't large.
Please don't make that noise again, Harvey.
I like a man who's willing to burn for his swag. How do you fare on water? Come closer. Post giant, I'm gonna bite close.
Here I need, oh, you New Yorkers, can't you dance the polka to me way? Yes, I'm deep, my dear, I need, oh, you New Yorkers, can't you dance the polka when I got inside the hill?
There's something I want to tell you. After I got shot, you want to know the very first thing that entered my mind? Before I blacked out. Coins. I'm 8 years old again, on a tour of the U.S. Mint. I'm listening to a guide explain how coins are made, how they're punched out of sheet metal, how they're rimmed and beveled, how they are stamped and cleaned, and how each and every batch of coins are personally examined just in case any have slipped through with the slightest imperfection. That's what popped into my head. I am a coin in the United States Army. I was minted in the year 1980. I've been punched from sheet metal. I've been stamped and cleaned. My ridges have been rimmed and beveled.
Do you want to see some more?
Yeah, absolutely, yes, if you don't mind.
Put this, glove on there.
Thanks.
This is a humorous one. This is a satirical coin.
This is massive.
Yeah, William Jennings Bryan, when he ran for president, he believed in... No, don't turn it over. Leave it here. Do you remember that he had the free silver policy, you remember?
Oh.
And McKinley was his opponent, and he's... Right here. Now, see this, that's a real silver dollar. That's the size of a silver dollar.
Wow.
And McKinley said that if Bryant had his way, then the silver dollars would be that big. Like, yeah.
That's amazing.
Can you imagine?
No.
Walking around with that in your pocket.
Yeah. That's really funny.
Been up all night staring at you, wondering what's on your mind. I've been this way with so many before, but this feels like the first time.
Just borrow them for me, will you? Thanks.
Pete! You forgot your change.
Okay, let's get started on the thing. Tell me everything.
Like what?
The guy, where does he live?
Around the corner.
Okay.
Bob.
What?
I want to tell you something.
All right.
I was thinking, you know, we might hold off on this thing.
You want to hold off on it?
I was thinking we might, yeah.
You want to quiz me on some coins? You want to show some coins to me? List prices, the blue book?
You want to see the book?
Sure.
I just picked it up last week.
Oh.
The values aren't current.
Uh-huh.
Silver.
Uh-huh.
What's a rarity?
Well, that's got to be fairly steady, huh?
I'm saying against what isn't.
Uh-huh.
But the book gives you the general idea.
You got to have a feeling for your subject.
The book can give you that.
This is what I'm saying to you. One thing makes all the difference in the world.
What?
Knowing what the fuck you're talking about. And it's so rare, Don. It's so rare. What do you think a 1929 S. Lincoln head penny with the wheat on the back is worth? We got to know what condition we're talking about.
Okay, what condition?
Any of them. You tell me.
Well, pick one.
Okay. I'm going to pick an easy one. Excellent condition. 1929 S.
It's worth about $36.
No.
More?
Well, guess.
Just tell me, is it more or less?
What do you think?
More.
No.
Okay. It's worth, I got to say, 1860.
No.
Then I give up.
20 fucking cents.
You're full of shit.
My mother's grave.
Give me that blue book. Go beat that.
That's what I'm saying, Don. You got to know what you're talking about.
You want to take the book?
No.
I like it because of the art on it.
Uh-huh.
Because it looks like something.
Uh-huh. Just worth anything.
Huh? We don't know yet.
Oh.
We're gonna look it up.
What, tonight?
A man of honor always pays his debts and keeps his word.
I'm going to be late for school.
As I recall, it got me my first date with you.
I wouldn't leave something like that up to chance.
I don't. I make my own luck.
All rise. The Honorable Judge Freeman presiding.
The world is cruel, and the only morality in a cruel world is chance. Unbiased, unprejudiced, fair. His son's got the same chance she had. 50-50.
What happened to Rachel was a chance. We decided to act. We three.
Then why was it me who was the only one who lost everything?
It wasn't.
The Joker chose me.
Because you were the best of us. He wanted to prove that even someone as good as you could fall.
And he was right.
You're the one pointing the gun, Harvey. So point it at the people responsible.
Fair enough. You first. My turn.
Harvey, you're right. Rachel's death was my fault. Please don't punish the boy. Please punish me.
I'm about to. Tell your boy it's gonna be all right, Gordon. Lie. Like I lied.
It's going to be all right, son.
upset the established order, and everything becomes chaos. I'm an agent of chaos. Oh, and you know the thing about chaos? It's fear. You live. You die. Now we're talking.
Picked up Rachel Wirtz.
It must have been Maroney's man.
Shut up! Are you telling me that you're gonna protect the other traitor in Gordon's unit?
I don't know. He never told me. Listen, Dent, I swear to God, I didn't know what they were gonna do to you.
That's funny. Because I don't know what's gonna happen to you either.
Crazy old lady lived alone down in Fremont. No friends, no relatives. The day the county buries her, nobody even shows. A couple days later, someone from the state tax office comes poking around and sees his trunk in her attic. What does he find? A motherload of rare coins, totally uncirculated, like they just came out of the mint. Maybe her husband who died a while back and the coins from years ago. Maybe she didn't even know they were there. So being there no relatives or will, the state confiscates them, right? And they're gonna sell them, auction them off. But before they do that, my friends, these coins have to be appraised. And that happens right here in San Francisco at the Professional Coin Grading Service.
What's the most you ever lost on a coin toss?
Sir?
The most you ever lost on a coin toss?
I don't know. I couldn't say.
Call it.
Call it?
Yes.
For what?
Just call it.
Well, we need to know what we're calling it for here.
You need to call it. I can't call it for you. It wouldn't be fair.
I didn't put nothing up.
Yes, you did. You've been putting it up your whole life. You just didn't know it. You know what date is on this coin?
No.
1958. It's been traveling 22 years to get here. And now it's here. And it's either heads or tails. And you have to say, call it.
Well, look, I need to know what I stand to win.
Everything.
How's that?
You stand to win everything, call it.
All right. Heads then.
Well done. Don't put it in your pocket.
Sir?
Don't put it in your pocket. It's your lucky quarter.
Where you want me to put it?
Anywhere, not in your pocket. Or it'll get mixed in with the others and become just a coin. Which it is.
Personal items?
Yes?
You only needed 4 stamps.
Oh, well. Guess I could afford the extra 50 cents. I don't think this is my stuff.
We gotta jam the outside reader.
Mm-hmm.
And along with making us legit comes cash. Tons of it. I mean, what do you think we're doing out here in the middle of the desert? It's all this money. This is the end result of all the bright lights and the comp trips, of all the champagne and free hotel suites, and all the broads and all the booze. It's all been arranged just for us to get your money. That's the truth about Las Vegas.
Last one, Doc.
Truck had 10 quarters, exactly 10 quarters.
Well, maybe they were making long distance phone calls.
No. For the bridge. What? For the toll on the bridge.
While I'm considering your offer, I want a suite at the Fairlawn Hotel.
You know, I'm here to cut you a deal. I am not here to bend over and take it up the ass on you. Here, here's a quarter. Do yourself a favor. Call your lawyer. You're going back to jail.